It's like 1986 all over again. Look at this. Old cathode ray TV, capacitors, maybe the flux kind. Wow. Oh my God. Look at this place.
Face to face with the control panel for the massive antenna outside, the nerve center for the Duga radar,
the tuck 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 tuck, the woodpecker. This is what generated it. These are the units that are actually generating the 50-60 megawatts of electrical power that is being used to detect incoming missiles. From what I understand, they would have been bouncing waves off of the ionosphere. And as the intercontinental ballistic missile was launched, its exhaust plume would have disrupted that radio wave. What that means is it literally can detect things over the horizon, over the bend of the Earth, which would make sense in the training room that we saw earlier. It showed the Earth, it showed the sort of the extent of where that radar could reach. This is an amazing location. There are just trays and trays. This is how you computed in the early 80s. I mean, there's just a lot of calculations that need to be done to make that determination. Is this a missile being launched? This is the best of Soviet technology circa 1980.
amps, 125,000 kilovolts. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 units on each side. That's a lot of power coming into this place.
It looks like the Duga could put out roughly the same amount of power used by 25,000 homes.
It needed power, which would make sense for them to build the nuclear power plant.
Connecting the dots, I believe it's possible that what the Soviets were trying to cover up before, during, and after the Chernobyl accident was more than a radar facility, but a military base that could be instrumental in strikes against the West. For the Soviets, the relationship between the Chernobyl power plant and the Duga was tightly intertwined.
You take out Chernobyl, you take out this facility.
Perhaps this is why the Soviets kept Chernobyl running, despite the warnings. But could it also be a reason that their arch nemesis, America, would want the nuclear reactor shut down? That could have put Chernobyl on the CIA's hit list. Before coming back to Chernobyl, I met with two former U.S. intelligence agents. They told